What's up with the colors of chameleons? They come and go. They come and go. Changing color is a rarity in the animal world and also a mystery. Until now. Hey everybody, thank you for watching DNews today. I'm Trace and I am right here on our brand new set. I know you're excited. We're excited, I'm excited, you're excited, everybody's excited. Chameleons change color so well that they are well known across the planet for doing so, and their name is synonymous with someone who is good at changing their look, behavior, or opinions as their situation changes. Most people think chameleons change color for camouflage, but that's not it at all. Only the males can change color, and they do so to communicate danger to other nearby chameleons, or for a mating display, ladies. It's a pretty dramatic show when a chameleon swaps its green for a bright red, and thanks to new research, we now know how they do it. Researchers from the University of Geneva looked at the skin cells of chameleons to observe how they change color. Within their skin, it turns out, chameleons have these cells called iridophores. Suspended within those cells are tiny guanine nanocrystals, which are formed into a lattice structure. When relaxed, the chameleon's iridophore lattices are contracted and mainly reflect blue light. But when excited, the chameleon expands, and three-dimensional lattices expand along with them, reflecting different wavelengths of light. Below that layer, there's another layer of skin with even larger nanocrystals, which reflect near-infrared light, providing passive thermal protection. Which is great because these cold-blooded animals can't change their body temperatures. Changing that base layer may be one way that they can affect how much near-infrared light they're absorbing, because that's going to change how much heat is absorbed into their body too. Camouflage is also called cryptic coloration, or a color and pattern that makes an animal difficult to discern from its surroundings. It's concealed. The ability to change colors isn't unique to chameleons. Some fish, frogs, insects, crustaceans, cephalopods, and other lizards can do it too, but they don't have these nanocrystals. This research is the first time that's been seen in reptiles. Other animals use different methods of color shifting as well. Cuttlefish, for example, can also change their colors at will, but rather than crystal-filled iridophores, they use chromatophores. Chromatophores are sacs of a single pigment of color surrounded by a muscle. The cuttlefish has learned to widen or constrict that sac to show more or less of that color pigment. Invertebrates like cephalopods use chromatophores too, and for more on that, you can check out our video exploring how the disco clam can reflect light like a disco ball. Over time, evolution, mutation, and simply breeding with others can cause changes in the colors of species, humans included. All blue-eyed humans descended from a single mutated ancestor. You're all mutants, you're welcome. Usually because those animals which have these colorful adaptations tend to survive better than the ones without those colorful adaptations. Zebra stripes confuse predatory eyes, helping to disguise individuals and making the herd look a lot more massive. Background matching camouflage helps both predators like tigers blend in with their environment, as well as helping their prey hide by resembling its surroundings. But these adaptations take many generations to develop. Active color change, that's a whole different thing and pretty rare in the animal kingdom. Before this research, scientists believed chameleons changed color the same as cuttlefish or octopuses, but once they put the skin cells into a super magnifying electron microscope, they were able to see this unique and super cool system for reflecting light. But how do you think humans camouflage into our surroundings? Do we? Why or why not? Tell us down in the comments and subscribe for more DNews. Also, check out this video about the disco clam. It's really great. Thanks for watching DNews, everybody. We'll see you later.